Hey guys, it's Broker Bears, and welcome back to my FIFA 17 MCAR Perm Career Mode, where last time I left off, I won the league, and I got through in the semifinal of the cup. Standard stuff, really, and now in this episode, this will be actually the last episode of this career mode. This game against NG la la la, or however the fuck you say that. It is the cup final, and the second game of this match, this episode will be the last game of not only the career mode but of the league season, which after which I'll lift the league title. So hopefully, gonna lift two trophies in this episode, or guaranteed to do one. Which is more than Liverpool will do anytime soon, because they're out of the FA Cup. And just so you know, it's only half time when I'm recording this. I just can't fucking watch that bullshit anymore, because I don't recognize that team. This is not Liverpool. But I'm not doing that anymore. I'm making a stand. Until Liverpool can give me a reason to want to watch it. I'm not going to waste my time.
Great play from the attacker. Got to be. Got in the way.
Now's a play for a
throw. That's what everyone should do. To take a stand and say, hey, this cannot continue.
It went in well.
Something needs to change.
But he's shut off now. The ball's loose. Goalkeeper made the save, but he couldn't hold it.
Everyone realizes it, except the people in charge of Liverpool. And no, for anyone wondering, I'm not blaming Jurgen Klopp. He's trying to work. He's trying to do the best he can with what he has. He's not being given enough by the owners. Chris. If you guys can tell me how many players have Liverpool who reportedly made a bid for, how many have they even been linked to, honestly, not just fucking rumors, because the answer will be fucking stupid if we're looking at the rumors. How many players have Liverpool been for? He must say, hey, yeah, they might be interested in saying this player, that player, this player, that player. How many players? And you know what's funny? The fact that I have the comments disabled means that you are all correct. Zero. Nada. Fucking no one. Everyone else is fucking trying to do some January business. Liverpool are sitting on their hands and letting top four or go away. I thought we wanted to get top four, but apparently not. Apparently not. I'm not going to dwell on it anymore.
Has opened the scoring. 1-0 here.
Still want to support the team, but I am not watching them anymore. Not until they can give me a reason to want to watch them.
Block the defender. Berisha.
As is, the form is so bad. I knew Wolves were going to beat them. I knew Liverpool were going to lose to Wolves. Wolves. My friend, who's a Liverpool fan. In his whole life as well. Well, he's a year or two older than me. He's pretty much been a fan longer than I have technically. He has said 100% Wolves are gonna win. He even put a bet on Wolves so he can get some money out of it. It's kind of then the depression of watching Liverpool fail again. And the funny thing is, he's making money as they fail. Any Liverpool fans out there are betting? I mean, it's probably too late to put a bet on Wolves because their price is going to be fucking crazy. Best time we've been at the start of the game, but
possession given away once more.
For any upcoming games, probably not the Chelsea one, because they wouldn't have been anywhere near a good price against Chelsea whatsoever. I mean, you're going to have to put a shit ton. You probably have to put a shit ton of money on Chelsea. He's winning on Tuesday to get any kind of a reward back, but yeah, make some profit on it.
Switch on the.
If we're going to be terrible, take advantage of it.
Deflected in by the goalkeeper. Goalkeeper was reaching for.
Like I'm doing here, and you're playing terrible, and I'm taking advantage of it. It's now 3-0.
Strong enough touch.
Badul with two goals.
Well, they've widened the margin now. 3-0 they lead.
It's an knee with one. It's looking all good.
It goes out wide again. Let's see what the ref's going to do. Position here.
He's got his shot off now.
Oh, and it's over the bar. And it's going to be a minimum of 3 minutes to be played of added time. There's some potential in this move.
Knee.
Watch it then. And that's the referee signalling for half time.
I thought I might make it 4-0 before the break, but not the case. 3-0 is good. Alright. Excuse me. My voice is fucking shot from shouting at the telly in vain.
Now they've got a chance in this part of the pitch. Well, when they do say, you've been in these matches about the psychology of getting it right on the big day, you would have thought ability-wise it's
a real chance here. He's reached it and turned it aside.
And it's going to be his throw here. And in goes the cross.
The shot's up. That's a good block.
Badul! Aw. Oh, I thought he'd completed his hat trick there. But the keeper saved it. Wow, look at that. Badul has completed his hat trick. But I don't know if you guys noticed. The two goalkeepers almost have the exact same names, eh? And then, like, only a few different letters is separating them. That is crazy.
So they're looking for more at 4-0. Berisha. Attacking now. That's his game, isn't it?
Okay, that's... Go. goal. Or goal. Into
a quite a dangerous position now.
Helen! Oh.
And here's the shot.
He's blocked that well. And the referee spotted that deflection. He's pointed from the corner.
So I think it's safe to say that the this match is won. Would it be fair to say that it's 4-0 coming up to the 78th minute? They need to get 5 goals in 20 minutes, which is the goal every 4 minutes.
Here's a chance to attack. Now they can go forward.
How? Hello, referee.
Sustained attacking football, but when they lose it, as they've done now, it's just a risk that they might get caught out. That's great defending there, stopping that attack. On the attack here.
Come on. Drew Hagar. Penalty. Oh, come on!
Of substitutes, we're going to see
now. You're completely fucking bullshitting me, right?
And then he went, just diverted it away. 10 minutes left of regular time. Well, they're in a good position here. It has been
Hello.
A case of the die being cast pretty early in this match.
And go. Helen. Ah! Ball stolen from his feet. Yeah, as I was trying to get a shot away. Free kick? Nope. Of course not.
Well, this attack got a bit of menace to it. Face to try and hit it now. What a lovely finish that
ball. Oh, scores again. And that's 4 goals. This dude is on fire in this final.
There's another one for them.
Well, it's certainly going to help the goal difference. It might be important at the end of the season.
Great. He touch.
Good look here.
Pitch to control the ball. Oh, and beautifully slide home.
5-0 and the game underway again.
Very. He could perform.
3 minutes to be added on.
Good forward play from I'm not sure how it's pronounced. I'm probably butchering it 6 different ways. But the trophy is won, and that's the important thing.
The champions, Alan.
Your absolute joy.
And the players are going crazy.
They've worked long and hard, haven't they, over the course of the last 9 months or so, and boy, they deserve it.
Yeah.
These are special moments for a very successful team. Congratulations to them. Wonderful scenes of joy here, and no wonder they're milking the moment. Want to make absolutely the most of this.
Well, they're a proper team, aren't they? They've stuck together, defended really well in this competition.
Holy shit, that's the most fucking massive.
Fully deserved winners.
And, you know, your man just comes along, fucking picks it up, no problem. That thing looks like it weighs a lot. It looks... fucking hell. Bigger than your man's head. And to be fair, her no players have really big heads in this game, and they all seem to be the same in basic shape. Hey!
On the field with those off at the fans.
Hey, fucking hell, that it does. It looks like it really. It looks really big. Am I the only one who thinks that? It looks like it. Like, wait, is a lot, and you know, your man's just carrying it around like it's a fucking pebble. Well, he must be super strong. Prize money, that gives me only a million. But hey. It's fine by me. This game doesn't really matter, but go up. Oh. On top. Give the players that have played almost every single game, with maybe the exception of the goalkeeper, who only came in when got injured, and Milojevic missed a few games due to injury, got a few suspensions because I was a fucking idiot near the start of the career mode. But my last game came in the Russian career mode. Oh, it went by really quickly. Now, maybe that's because I do four for these videos every week, or what, but yeah. So tomorrow's video that will hit your boxes will be a different career mode for those of you wondering. Yes, the secondary career modes are continuing. It's only January. I know, I'm flying through them. I don't know what I'm going to do. Oh, fuck. This rate, I might end up running out of leagues because my randomizer seems to be keep picking. Decider keeps picking teams that aren't in European competitions, which is good because unless they're in the Champions League, I'm not participating in any European competitions because I've already won the Europa League with Lille, so I have no need to win it again. I have no point to win it again. Think EA should add in a guard of honor or animation.
I mean it can at first glance look cautious, but
like in Liverpool, in the last in my Liverpool promo when I won the Premier League, the next game, if that was real, if a team wins the title before the end of the season, whoever they play, ex-Norm, it's like, it seems to be a tradition that they give the team a card of honor.
Well, we're here today to watch the champions. With the title already sealed, nice and relaxed.
Oh, yeah.
So, is asking too much to have that in? Like, you can't have... You can have the players coming out, but you can't have, like, you can't set up that the players are standing on this, the opposition team are standing on this, I don't know, he's clapping as the player first come through.
Really good goal, and the celebrations reflect that. The supporters are going crazy.
I mean, I think it would be a nifty little feature, and it would give a bit more of a real-life feel to it, and EA wanted, like, the game to feel more real. Well, that's one way to do it. Yeah, that's one way to accomplish that.
Opened the scoring, 1-0 here. Well, this could have an edge to it, isn't it? Because I know the home team are pretty upset with what happened in the away game when they were beaten. They weren't too pleased about their performance, or indeed the reception that they got.
They got taught a lesson that day, and I'm sure that
maybe
by the losing team since, so it might be a closer one here.
Maybe you guys don't like that idea, but I think it would add a bit more. It would make the game feel a bit more real. Or, you know, it would add something to it. It really would.
Now they've got a chance in this part of the pitch.
The thing, and these are just ideas, they probably won't put it in because it's career mode. And there's no situation in Ultimate Team that would warrant it, because when you win the title in a season in Ultimate Team, you just go straight up. You don't play the rest of the game. So you're just, oh, you're gone. Look at that. Goodbye.
Into the attacking third. Gonna tie his luck. He's kept it up.
I mean, that doesn't make any sense because, I mean, like, that doesn't happen in real life.
And he's up for the header.
That'd be like whoever wins the championship this year, whether it be Brighton or Newcastle or some other team. That'd be like saying that as soon as he win, have the championship won, they don't play any more games. No, unless it's the last game of the season that they win the title in, they aren't going to play any more games.
Good work by the goalkeeper.
So, I mean, these are just ideas. Maybe I'm overthinking it, but yes, a bit of conversation. And I like to spout out some thoughts and stuff like that when I do these videos. You know, I mean, I could just give you guys gameplay with no commentary.
Or
I could
position where they wouldn't be expecting
to maybe come up with stuff beforehand, but
so, but there seems to be
there's, you know, random and stuff off the quick like questions and answers and just thoughts. I like that approach. Just if something comes to mind, I can think about it and play it in a video. So, well, that's the beauty of me. Yeah. Obvious YouTuber.
Can't see this too many times, this goal.
Yeah, sign of a bit of experience there. Didn't try and put his foot through it. Knew exactly where we wanted to place it.
I can use this hobby to share my ideas with the world. And some people will listen, and some people won't. That's the beauty of this platform.
There's good progress with this attack. The shot's up! Delightful!
I made it 3-0 just before the break. Hey, just to add fuel. Pull to that fire, or before or it goes out. Onana has been a really good player. If he turns out to be anywhere near as good in real life as he has been in this career mode, then Spurs have a gem on their hands. Another one. Because they have a good few gems on their hands. They fucking they're fucking magicians with their fucking coal. Well, you know, you give Spurs coal in a no time, they'll have a huge sack of fucking diamonds. You'd be like, what the fuck? Like, this is what we do.
The first one-sided.
A lot of teams get praised for their youth producing and work with youth players. There's young players and players know.
Now it goes into the wider areas where they've got a wing.
I mean, any of us even knew who Harry Kane was a few years ago. So, Duke, who gets a chance, he starts scoring, and now he's one of the best strikers in the Premiership. And I guarantee you, if he keeps up great form, rumors will never go away unless he moves, that they'll be linking him to every team under the sun with a bit of money. Manchester United, Chelsea, it's even already happening. I've heard the rumors linking him to those clubs last season. Oh, he was supposed to be moving to Manchester United in the summer. Or if he has an urgency. Even more eyes will be on it. And because people will say, okay, it wasn't a one-season deal. There's more to him than me in that one season. And showed. He's not just, one season, that's it. Poof, done. And see you bye. He has so many players have been. Harry Kane. His plan. He has every intention of being very consistent. What could be a very good long career. Sure, same with guys like Dele Alli. I mean, when he was at MK Dons, everyone was like praising Dele Alli. When Spurs signed him, a lot of people were saying, like, let's see how the kid reacts. Let's see how he gets on. And he's become an amazing player. And just always have to be super young. Spurs seem to really pull out of nowhere. Or they can also do with starters who are already on a relatively big stage, like Son, who they got from Bayer Leverkusen, and Eric Lamela, and Christian Eriksen. I mean, no offense to Ajax, but Christian Eriksen is probably doing some of the best stuff he's ever done in his career. Spurs.
Pedro Ken.
And every time he puts in a good performance, people are like, this Eriksen is really good, and he has a lot to offer. For the world of football. Well, for his career.
He's really been on form.
So.
Well, a wonderful achievement.
It's not like it's just the first time Spurs have done that. I mean, they turned a left back who no one knew into one of the best players in the world. That player? Gareth Bale. They turned Luka Modric into one of the best central midfielders in the world. Spurs are really good at that stuff. And I don't think they get the credit. They don't always get the credit they deserve. They should get more praise for that, I really think. And so, if they keep this up, I can definitely see Spurs winning a Premier League title sometime in the future. I know Arsenal fans are probably dreading that day, because I think they can see it coming as well. They're just like, please let us stop being so inconsistent to the point where we can win one before then. Because that's all Arsenal fans hope, is that they can somehow win the Premier League again before her Spurs win it.
That's going to be a yellow card for this player.
That's one thing they don't want to happen. They already let Leicester win the Premier League. Begin their Premier League drought. when a lot of people were saying Arsenal were one of the top teams that could have prevented Leicester from winning it. And rip! Yeah, after that, that Danny Welbeck stuff at the end of the last season, it was Arsenal's inconsistency that cost them the title. Well, Irwin, at least they'd be the current Premier League champions in life. There's poor performance wouldn't be. He's so alarmed. I mean, because they'd be just, you know, they a one-off top four.
Yeah, it does seem to be the case. Whether the one manager has helped his players got them ready.
As it is, they're the one-off Premier League champions. They may end up getting relegated if they don't improve their form. So, I mean,
well, there is the final whistle, and that confirms
just the thoughts I've had, and that will be it. I'm gonna let the players just drink it in this moment. And I will go with the celebrations of their league, of them receiving the league trophy. I will see you all tomorrow for the start of a brand new career. But until then, thanks for watching. Home and joy.
Proper team, aren't they?
Smash like button, you did subscribe if you're new. Until next time, I hope you all have a very nice day.
So fully deserved winners.
There they go. They are the champions. Real joy here, total happiness. You play the game for these kind of moments. If you're in it, you want to win it, and they have won it.
Yeah, no wonder they're going to the fans, because those supporters have played a huge part in this triumph. They've stuck by these players when they've needed them the most.
Special scenes here. Well, you have to have the team photo, and they're getting ready for it now.
Yeah, one of those lovely scenes that you'll hang on the wall back at home.